Hello everyone, my name is Jaime Piñero, UMass Entomology. I work for Stockbridge with a research and teaching appointment. I also work for UMass Extension when it comes to extension work. So what you see here is an experimental plot. It's a preliminary study, and the focus is the brown marmorated stink bug. We are testing the effectiveness of trap cropping. You have buckwheat in this block. You have sunflower in this block. You have sorghum, and then you also have pearl millet. So trap cropping has proven to be effective against other insect pests. With the brown marmorated stink bug, there is research done showing that sunflower is a very good trap crop plant. That means that this plant attracts stink bugs. Buckwheat is also very good. Sunflower and sorghum, and then pearl millet. So we have pheromone lures. You can see the sticky cards, which are clear sticky cards, baited with the brown marmorated stink bug pheromone. And then we have four more blocks. They have the trap crops, but no pheromone. So the goal of this study is to determine if you can bring the brown marmorated stink bug in higher numbers when you combine trap cropping with the pheromone. So we have a control, which is the pheromone alone, no trap cropping. And then we have another control, which is sticky cards with no trap cropping and no pheromone. So we're hoping this shows to growers, maybe they can improve monitoring efforts, or maybe this can become an attract and kill site. Because when the buckwheat and the sunflower produce seed, it's called the milk stage. That's when they become very attractive to the brown marmorated. So we really have to work closely with the phenology, the blooming period, because you will not be spraying when they're in bloom. But after bloom, when you have the seeds, we expect these plants to become attractive. Maybe more when you have the pheromone. So we're going to submit a proposal for funding to do this research at a bigger scale, maybe in 10 different farms for the next 2 years. This is preliminary, it's a small test, and we're working together with my students to determine if we can accomplish this goal of improving monitoring efforts for the brown marmorated when you have the pheromone and trap cropping combined.
Okay.
So now we are at an X block. This is an experiment involving beneficial nematodes. Those are called entomopathogenic nematodes, but that means insect killing nematodes. So this experiment, we're comparing two nematode species and also comparing two different rates, application rates, low and high density of nematodes. So what you see is an emergence cage which has about 35 fruits. We also placed yesterday a Ploncurculio larvae, and then we applied the nematodes. In this particular treatment, we have SC plus SR, those are the two species, the acronym, low density for each, and replicate number one. So we have 7 different treatments times 4 replications. That means that we have 28 cages, 7 in this row, 7 on each of these 4 rows. And the idea is that the nematodes are going to kill Ploncurculio larvae in the soil. We have done this work before for several years, so we know it works very well, but we just need to increase the level of information, the confidence for growers. When you apply nematodes to the soil, you can reduce Ploncurculio populations by 85%. That means that if you have 6 Ploncurculios emerging from the soil as adults, you are going to get just 1. When you apply nematodes. So that will be the ratio. If you apply nematodes, you get 1. If you don't apply nematodes, you get 6 on average. So which is another way of suppressing populations for the summer. Those Ploncurculios are going to feed on fruit, so they can also do damage by feeding on the fruit. If you don't control them, then you can have higher populations for overwintering. So next year you can have high numbers again. But when you apply nematodes, and you can suppress this summer population, then they are feeding less, and you can reduce potentially the numbers for next year. So it's not expensive. We're doing more research, but the idea is to be able to work now with growers to be able to demonstrate how effective this is. For example, yesterday in one organic orchard in New Hampshire, we provided the grower with 1 billion nematodes. So yesterday at night, he applied the nematodes to the soil in the perimeter of the block. That's when you have more plum curculio injury, more larvae in the soil. Today, Jim Krupa, UMass, he applied 1 billion nematodes to Rock Mountain. It's about 2.5 acres. And we know that is a hot spot for plum curculio. So again, this morning he applied 1 billion nematodes, and we're hoping this is going to reduce the numbers. And we also provided today 1 billion nematodes to another grower. And he's right now he's applying the nematodes in the block. So we have these three places where we're trying to show that it's not expensive, it's not difficult to do, and can provide benefits to growers.